Hey, what's going on, everybody? My name is Jay Cruz, and in this video, I'm going to give you 5 tips on how you can be a better music director and deal with some of those cranky musicians. This week, I had a good friend of mine reach out to me and ask me my opinion on approaching musicians who are not quite coming in prepared. They're either not knowing their music, fumbling through, or not even bothering to learn the music at all. Now look, you could be a part of a worship team, you could be a part of a band. Regardless, everyone runs into these kinds of issues, and as a band director, you need to know how to approach people to be able to bring the best out of them. So here we go, 5 tips on how to make you better at this, and hopefully it'll help you. Tip number one, don't be afraid of confrontation. Look, in today's world, people hear the word confrontation, they immediately become fearful of it because confronting someone typically means arguing with someone. That's not what confronting is. Confronting is just communication with a focal point. If there's an issue between you and a team member, especially something that's preventing you and a band member from being able to play together, minister together, whatever your situation is, or maybe they've become a crutch and they're kind of holding the team back from progressing to where you feel the team can be, you have to have these kind of conversations. They're necessary. It's something that will take your team a long way. Ignoring these issues might cause you to become frustrated, maybe even cause the team members to become frustrated and ultimately become discouraged and not want to be a part of the group anymore. Tip number two, accept responsibility. When you're confronting someone, especially when you're confronting them about not coming to a rehearsal prepared, it's important that you approach them a specific kind of way. I think that it's best that as a music director, as the leader, you should accept responsibility by asking them this way. Hey, I noticed you've been having a little bit of a hard time coming in prepared to the rehearsals. You've been struggling through some of the songs. Is there something that I can do to help you? By asking that question, you do a couple of things. Number one, you accept responsibility. Maybe there's something you're not doing to help them prepare. Maybe they're not getting enough time to prepare. Maybe they're not getting the songs in time before their rehearsal or the actual event. Maybe you're doing it the day of, which is like really difficult for any musician, let alone a musician who maybe is early in the game here. The second thing that it does is it shows you're actually listening to that team member, their needs, what they're struggling with, what their frustrations are. Trust me when I tell you, it'll make you a better leader when you can have that kind of a conversation with another team member. It's one of the most respectful ways you can approach someone about their time, specifically if you have more of a volunteer or someone who's not getting paid to be there. They're doing it because they love it. We don't want to cause an atmosphere where they're no longer enjoying it. Tip number three, stay true to your word and hold your team members accountable. After you've spoken to such a team member and they've told you what they're struggling with, now you want to actually stick to your word and present them with the solutions to their problems. For example, if they're not getting enough time with the music, you probably want to start sending your music out a little bit more in advance. A week before, maybe even 2 weeks before. Trust me when I tell you, it's possible to prepare in advance. By you preparing, it'll set up your team member for success and they'll come in prepared. But now that you've taken the time out to do that, you can successfully hold them accountable. Now you can say, look, I've taken the time out to make sure that I'm preparing for you. All I ask is that you show the same honor and respect and come in prepared. Tip number four, communication and relationship. I've never once been able to instantly connect with a person and share these amazing moments without having developed some form of a relationship with that person. Relationship is key. Look, I'm not telling you that you have to take your team members on vacations with you and spend holidays, but what I am saying is that you have to get to know them a little bit. By getting to know them, you're gonna develop communication skills with them. See, not everyone is the same. Everyone communicates differently. You can approach certain people a certain kind of way, but you won't know that until you actually get to know them a little bit. If your only form of communication with someone is to point out their faults or to scold them, that's not good communication, and you're going to develop a very angry team member and someone who's going to become bitter and just not want to be there. You want to be careful with that. You want to be able to communicate successfully. Therefore, yes, I want to point out your flaws, but I also want to point out how good of a job you're doing. Remember to show that encouragement. I believe encouragement is just as important as critique, and it'll help you grow. And last but not least, one of the more important ones to me, record and listen back to yourselves as a team. Listening back to yourselves is so important to becoming a successful unit. Some of the things that you're hearing as a leader, where someone's kind of fumbling through certain parts and not quite coming prepared, maybe they don't hear it. Maybe they don't realize how it affects the team as a unit. Recording yourselves and hearing it back, even if it's just on an iPhone during a rehearsal, can really bring awareness to the importance of coming in prepared and sounding your best. When they can hear themselves in a way that an audience member can hear them, it starts to change their perception of how important it is to come in prepared. How many times have you heard a recording of yourself and went, ah, man, I could have done that part a little bit better. I should change my sound a little bit, maybe get a little brighter, a little darker here. It's not quite translating well in this video. It's a very healthy acknowledgement, but what it also does is it encourages your team member to come up with those solutions on their own. Actually showing them a video of themselves may point out something that they've been missing all along. It will encourage them to actually come in prepared for the next time. I hope this video has helped you. If you have any tips that you want to add, please feel free to leave them in the comment section below. Don't forget to like this video, subscribe, hit that bell icon so you get all the alerts every time I upload a video. And feel free to check out my website and look me up on social medias at JCruzProject on everything. Thanks again for watching, and until next time.